प्रतिपूर्तं प्रकाशरूपं रूपं तस्या गजामुरीपुरीं माथुरीं गौरचंद्रायो राधिकाय तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय राधभक्ताय नमो आनंद लीलामय विग्रह हे दिव्य सुंदर तस्मै महाप्रेम रस प्रदाय चैतन्य चंद्राय नमो नमस्ते चैतन्य चंद्राय नमो नमस्ते चैतन्य चंद्राय नमो सुमुरली मनोरा राधिक रस कम कृपा निधे सुप्रियचरण किंकरीं कुरु त्वैवास्मी त्वैवास्मी नाजीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय देवी तं नयामि चरणानि
Gosto, I offer my sustained Dandavat Puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands and thousands of times, at the lotus feet of my holy master, my supremely worshipable spiritual Gurudev. Asmadeva Paramarada Tama Guru Pada Padwa, Nitya Lila Pravishnu, Om Vishnu Pada Ashtotara Sattva Sri, Rupanuga Acharya Varya, Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami. Secondly, I offer my pranam thousands of times at the lotus feet of my Param Gurudev, to Srila Prabhupada and all of our Sri Rupanuga Gaudiya Guru Parampara. And finally, I offer my pranam to all the assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis. By the causes mercy of Sri Guru and Gauranga, we have been discussing this great treasure, Sri Bhajan Rahasya. It was compiled by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We have come to the second chapter. Here in the second chapter, there is an explanation of the various moods behind the second verse of Shikshastakam. Nam nam akari bahudani jasarva shakti satra pitani amatas marneil nakara etadrishi tabakripa bhagavan mamapi durdaivam idrisham iha janinanu raga. This corresponds to the stage of our development, sadhu sangha, or bhajana kriya. Sadhu sangha means the association of saintly persons. Asat sangha bhai, Krishna nama nai hai, namaksha bahirai, vatu nama kabu nai. Sri Jagadananda Pandit said that in the association of those who are not devoted to Krishna, in asat sangha, asat sangha cha gai vaishnava cha, stri sangi eka asadu, Krishna abhakta a. The sign of a Vaishnava is they have given up, they have left the asat sangha, materialistic association. Two types of materialistic association, those stri sangi eka asadu, one type of asadu is those who they are attached to the opposite gender, because the the attraction between male and female is the most basic form of bondage within this material world. Duality. So, those who associate inappropriately with the opposite gender, then they cannot progress, because that association causes the citta vikar, transformation of the citta. But to realize Krishna, you have to become nirvikar, free from the modifications of the psychological body. So, that is one. And the other type, Krishna abhakta. Anyone who is not devoted to Krishna, their minds are avesh, absorbed in the vanity of the material ego and all of its extensions. This is why, even as we saw yesterday in the drama of Harishchandra, though he was dharmic, he was truthful, he was righteous, but this dharma is not the jaiva dharma, it is not the atma dharma. The dharma, the religion, the nature of the soul is to serve Krishna. But that dharma, that morality which is seen by the general people, is the morality related to the body and mind. And for a transcendental spiritual soul, just to identify with the body and mind is already to be lost in a state of narcissism. Completely lost in deep vanity. As long as we make a distinction between your belly, your stomach, and someone else's stomach, then you have to take birth in this material world. You know, if you have been fasting on Janmashtami till midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning, then it's time for prasada. Then all the sevaks in the mart, brahmacharis and others, then they have to serve everyone else. They cannot take themselves. They have to serve everyone else. And then in the end, they can take. So when you're fasting for a long time and then serving everyone else, then you get to realize, is there a difference between this stomach and that stomach? Or not? And then you can see whether you are bound in this material world or not. So, though ordinary dharma, worldly dharma and morality seems a wonderful thing, and for those who are not devotees, it is somewhat more beneficial for them to be dharmic than to be adharmic, of course. But still, it is a state of ignorance. It is a state of obliviousness to the presence of Sri Krishna, to the reality, to the Advaya Gyan Tattva, the non-dual absolute truth. So Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita in the end, Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. give up all the dharmas related to the body and the mind, Varnasham Dharma, and surrender yourself fully to me. So, those who are abhakta, they are not devotees of Krishna. By associating with them, then our body identification becomes compounded. It becomes reinforced. It's very difficult to overcome. So, Tosidas Ji said, Jinke priya narama videhi chajo koti vairi sam yadyapi paramas nahi. It means, because he's a devotee of Ram. So he said, if someone does not have love for Sitaram, then you should give them up as if they were 10 million deadly enemies coming to kill you. 10 million, koti vairi sam. If 10 million deadly enemies were all coming to kill you, what will you do? Hello? No. So, just you saying, yadyapi paramasanehi, even if they love you, even if they have affection for you, quickly get on your bicycle. Get out of there. So this is the sign of a Vaishnava. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad said, I would rather be put in a cage and lowered into a fire or embrace a crocodile than have the association of the materialistic, worldly minded persons. So, Srila, in this second chapter, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is quoting a verse. It is also quoted in Bhaktirasamrita Sindhu of Rupa Goswami, but the original verse is from the Hari Bhakti Sutta Dhai. Yasya satsangati pungsa manivatsya satadgunai sakula jayatato dhima sayutan eva sangsrayat. Now, this verse was actually, what can we say? We can say it was not spoken by a devotee. It was spoken by Hiranyakashipu, a big demon. But in a deeper sense, we can say it was also spoken by a devotee because he's the incarnation of Jai, the gatekeeper of Vaikuntha. But he's speaking a principle which is universally applicable in life. He's saying, Yasya satsangati pungsa manivatsya satadgunai. Our consciousness is manivat. Manivat means like a jewel, a crystal. So if you place a clear crystal or jewel on a red cloth, then it will reflect the color red. If you place it on a blue cloth, it will reflect the color blue. Whichever environment it's put in, it reflects those colors. So our consciousness is like that. That in the proximity of whomever we are associating with, then our consciousness begins to reflect their thoughts, feelings, their level of awareness begins to reflect in us, and we begin to morph into that level of awareness. So, if a person associates with materialistic persons, speaking with them as just in everyday ordinary activities, with attachment, you have attachment for them, then your consciousness will go down, 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 down. And just as they are firmly rooted in the identity that they are this physical body, their consciousness is like setting concrete. This is me. Of course this is me. What else could I be? But this body and mind, they're so fixed in that. They have nishta in that. Unshaking trust. So then you start to get a stronger and stronger identification.
But on the other hand, it works in the converse way, that if we associate with the sadhu, sadhu has no body identification at all. Nothing. Once I came into my Gurudev's room, he was sitting there. And he looked at me, he said, he was touching himself. Not himself, but the body. And he said, it is exactly like dry firewood. No feeling or identification at all. It is, the body is really foreign to the soul. Actually. So, when we associate with such persons, not only do we also gradually transform, that our consciousness starts to become like them. Not only do we start to become free from bodily awareness, but their detachment from the world is not the primary symptom of their consciousness. That's just incidental. The primary symptom of their consciousness is deep attachment to Krishna, to Radhika, to Lalita Vishakha, Rupa Manjari, all the associates of Krishna, the transcendental leelas of Krishna, they are deeply attached there. So by their association, gradually our consciousness begins to morph and be shaped and go in that direction also. So association is the key to transformation. But in that association, we have to be very respectful, very submissive. So in this second chapter of Bhajan Rahasya, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is quoting another verse, Krishneti yasigritam manasadriyeta dikshasti chet pranatibhischa bhajantamisham so susraya bhajana vigyam ananya anya nindari shunyaridam ipsita sangalapya. There are different levels of devotees. So the first level is someone who even once says, Hare Krishna. So that person, you have to, from your heart, respect them. Because they have chanted the name of your beloved Krishna. From the heart, we honor anyone who chants Krishna's name. But, dikshasti chet pranatibhischa bhajantamisham. If a person has received diksha, in the real sense of the word, vidvat rudi, the real sense of the word, that means that from their Gurudev, they have, by his mercy, become aware to some extent of their special relationship with Krishna. Then such Vaishnavas, not only do we honor them from the core of the heart, but we also bow down and we give dandavat pranam to them. Then, sususrayo bhajana vigyam ananya manya nindari shuniridam ipsita sangalabdhya. If a person is bhajana vigya, that means they have realization of the nitya seva, eternal service of Radha and Krishna. So such persons, not only do we honor them from the heart, not only do we give dandavat pranam, but susrusraya means we listen to them very, very carefully. Whatever they're saying, we try to assimilate that into our life. We try to follow them as far as we can, as far as our qualification allows, outwardly, and also their inner moods. And we try to serve them. Their manobishta, whatever is their innermost heart's desire, we try to serve that and please them. Then, yasya saksangati pungsamani vatsyasa tadgunai. All the bhavs in the heart of that transcendental Vaishnava, they'll be sankramit, reflected, and come to us like a miracle. What that sadhu spent 100 lifetimes realizing, if we approach in a humble mood of service, very eagerly, very enthusiastically and humbly and submissively, then what it took him so many lifetimes to realize, he can reflect into our hearts just in a moment, very short time. So Surustraya, Bhajanadigyam, Ananyamanya, Nindari Shunya Ridamipsita Sangalabdya. How can we tell if someone is on that level? Nindari Shunya Ridam. That person's heart is completely devoid of the desire to criticize anyone. Because they are Uttam Bhagavata. They see Krishna everywhere. Everyone is great. Everyone is worshipable. Everything is sacred. All are worthy of my honor. Everyone has love for Krishna, except for me. This is their part. So there's no one to criticize. They're not pointing. This is bad. This one is bad. Black heart, black face. So, by the Kripa Shakti, by the mercy of Supreme Lord, their vision is adjusted somewhat so that they can see like a Madhya Madhikari. And they can discriminate. Oh, this person is innocent, this person is devoted and so on, and they can give some instruction. So they adjust their vision, but it doesn't mean that their consciousness has come down. So, such persons, Srila Rupa Goswami said, Ipsita Sangha Labdhya. Such association is Ipsita, very much desirable for us in our life. We want that association. That would be our greatest success. Akshno phalam tvadrisha darshanam hi. The perfection of the eyes is to see, oh Vaishnav Thakur, the perfection of my eyes is to see. The perfection of the body is to serve you. Because such a person is extremely, extremely rare in this world. Durapa alpata pasa seva vaikuntava masu yatropati yate nityam deva deva janardana. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said to Ramananda Rai, the association of the associates of God who are near and dear to see Krishna is extremely rare. Those whose life has not become auspicious by fully engaging in devotional service and serving many Vaishnavas, then they cannot. It's very rare and difficult for them to get even a moment's association with such a great personality. Tulayama lavanapi na swagam na punabhavan bhagavat sanghi sangasya matyanam kimutashishaha. This verse two times, is there two times in Srimad Bhagavatam. Means tulayama. We should not compare. Tulayama means, don't compare. 1 second association. No, a fraction of a second of association. Tulayama lavanapi naswaragam to going to heaven. That means don't compare it with the fruit of performing all the karma kanda rituals and sacrifices of the Vedas by which you can go to heaven. Na puna tulayama lavanapi naswaragam na puna bhavan. Don't compare the association for a fraction of a second with a pure saint to becoming free from the cycle of repeated birth and death. Mukti, liberation. Why? Because Radha Krishna's seva is far, far beyond liberation. The happiness of liberation is not even one drop of the endless ocean of ananda transcendental joy in the service of Krishna. So Talayama Lebanapi Naswagam Napunabhavan Bhagavat Sanghi Sangasya Matyanam Kimutashisha. Bhagavat Sanghi Sangasya. The association of Bhagavat Sanghi. That means one who associates with Bhagavan, his name, his deity. So that refers to any sadhu, even a sadhak who is just a practicing devotee. Even his association cannot be compared to going to heaven or even being liberated. What to speak of the association of a siddha? So, here in the second chapter of Bhajan Rahasya, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is giving these verses for us to deliberate upon the importance of association of a sadhu and the way in which that association mangaludayena causes the awakening of all auspiciousness in our life. Our whole destiny is completely changed. Because by sadhu sangha comes bhajana kriya. One receives initiation and begins to engage in the activities of bhakti yoga. And by engaging in sadhana bhakti, it produces the results of kleshagni and shubhada. Kleshagni means whatever miseries and problems were coming, that no longer affects you. Either the problems will not come, or if they come, they don't affect you at all. You see that actually they're all favorable. They're helping. So, kleshagni and shubhada, one's life becomes auspicious. Auspiciousness in life is characterized by wherever you go, mysteriously, inexplicably. You meet people and they feel affection for you and they don't know why. You also don't know why. But anyway, that love is coming from others, and you also feel affection for all living beings, for everyone. That is auspiciousness. Heart has become very gentle, very kind. And also, one gets sadhu sangha. This is auspiciousness. And one feels happiness. One feels satisfied. So, bhajana kriya, when we engage in bhakti, these results develop. Our life is transformed. Anatta nivritti, and all four types of anattas we discussed yesterday, and each of the four, what were the four types? Raise your hand if you can name one. Yes?
Misconceptions regarding Shastra.
Yes, Swarup Brahm. The Brahm misconceptions, misunderstandings relating to the Swarup of things, like Jiva Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva, Sadhan Sadhya Tattva, and Bhajan Virodhi Brahm. The misunderstanding about what is detrimental to your practice. Okay. So then what was another one?
Asatrishna.
Yes, Asatrishna. What does it mean? Don't look in your notes. You have to write it down in your heart, not in the book.
One wants to enjoy material world.
Kind of, yes. That's part of it. Asat means the temporary and Trishna means thirst. So thirst for any temporary thing. So that includes not only thirst for enjoyment in this world, thirst for enjoyment in the next world, in heavenly planets, thirst for yoga siddhis, mystic powers, yoga siddhi, and navanidhi, the nine jewels of Kuvair, Padma and others. I won't even tell you about them, and then you can't want them. If I tell you, I know. So I'll not tell you about the navanidhi, the nine jewels of Kuvair. So, to give up the thirst for astasiddhi and navanidhi, and also the desire for liberation. That means just the problems that I'm suffering I experience should go away, because then when it's gone, then that was a temporary thing, because it's gone now. So it's also an asatrishna type of temporary person. So then another, yes, Rasikshika.
Matsarya.
Not exactly. That's part of one. Hridayatura balyam, yes. The weakness of heart. Of which Matsarya is one. What are another ones?
Freedom of reincarnation. Freedom from reincarnation.
No, here. The weakness of heart is Matsarya, enviousness, kutinati, duplicity, Pratishna, desire for recognition, name and fame, reputation. And one more?
Chasakti.
Yes, very good. Tucha asakti. Attachment. Yes, attachment for the very insignificant things. So, then there's one more anartha we discussed yesterday.
Aparad.
Yes, aparad. What were the four types of aparad?
Namaparad, Sevaparad.
Namaparad, Surupaparad. That is offense to the name of Krishna and offense to the Surup of Krishna, which is manifest in the form of 32 types of Seva Aparad. Then?
Damaparad.
Tadiya. Tadiya. That means what belongs to Krishna. So that includes the Dham, Yamuna, Govardhan, Ganga, the devotees. All of these things are in the Tadiya. And then the last one? Chitkana. Chitkana means the particles of consciousness. That is, all living beings. Don't offend any living being, not even an ant, because it will make an obstacle. Okay, so yesterday we were discussing how by practicing bhakti bhajana kriya in good association, then these anarthas are cleared. In this regard, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he is quoting verses of the Chatusloki Bhagavatam. Chatusloki Bhagavatam are the original four verses from which the whole Srimad Bhagavatam came. 18,000 verses of Srimad Bhagavatam came from these four seed verses. It's called the Chatusloki Bhagavatam. You find it in 2nd Canto, Chapter 9. Spoken by Sri Krishna himself to Lord Brahma. So, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given these verses because they are related to Swarup Brahm. By hearing about the Sambandha Gyan, general Sambandha Gyan, Abhideya, the process of bhakti and the goal of life, by hearing about this, then one becomes clear on all of these things and the Swarup Brahm misunderstandings go away. So I just want to touch one of those verses. Urite tam yat pratiyeta na pratiyeta chatmani tadvidyadatmanomayam yathabaso yathatamaha. So beautiful. This is the second of the four verses. Just to put it in context, the first verse is, the first two verses are on Sambandha Gyan. So the first verse, Supreme Lord says, Aham eva sameva gri nanyad yat sadasat param pascharam yadetatcha yovisiseta sosmeham. In the beginning, before the creation of cause and effect was manifest, only I existed. There's no beginning. It means before the creation. Before the creation began. But before that there was another creation. After there's another. The creation is a cycle which is going on. Creation, destruction, with no beginning and no end. So he's saying, Aham eva asam eva gre. Before the creation of the world, of cause and effect, only I existed. Pasjadam yateitatsa yovisisyeta sosmiham. And when the creation is dissolved, I exist. And in the middle, in the interim period before the creation and after the creation and before the destruction, in that intermediate period, only I exist. So here, Aham means Krishna. So now one may say, okay, I get the part about before the creation and after, but what about in the middle? It seems to me that, well, where is Krishna? I don't see him. And I'm seeing all these other things. So then Krishna, well, I can explain it. Now the second verse comes. Ritertam yat pratiyeta na pratiyeta chatmani tad vidya datmanumayam yatabhasho yatatama. Rite means without. Artha, substance. Yat pratiyeta means whatever you experience, which is not the actual substance, me, as explained in the previous verse. You should tadvidyatmanomayam, you should know that this is my maya, illusion. Na pratiyeta chatmani. And when you don't experience the Atma, then this is also Maya. So Maya has two aspects, that is Avaranatmaka and Vikshepatmaka. Avaranatmaka covers the soul's awareness of him, his own identity. And then Vikshepatmaka throws, Vikshep means to distract. His consciousness goes out into the ingredients of the world and becomes distracted and absorbed in that. So, Krishna said, tadvidyatatmanomayam yathabhasho yathatama. It is like abhas, that means a reflection, and tama, darkness. So here, abhas and tama refer to two aspects of maya. Maya, there is jiva maya and guna maya. Jiva maya is also called nimitta maya, and guna maya is also called upadan maya. So, the nimitta maya or jiva maya acts on the jiva. And that has vidyavritti and avidyavritti, that which gives knowledge, that is the power to distinguish between matter and spirit. And avidya, the avidyavritti has those two aspects, avaranatmaka covering the soul and vikshepatmaka, distracting. So then, that is abhas, the jiva maya. Then, tama, that is upadan, the ingredients of the world. From pradan, the basic ingredient of the world, all the elements are manifest. But actually, the pradan is only a potential. Where do all these forms come from? It is the Paramatma who enters into the pradan and he is himself manifesting all these forms. So this is the explanation of in the middle there's only me. Understand? So, by the jiva maya, in the form of avaranatmaka, we forget. We are covered. I am the soul? No, I don't know who I am. We forget that we are a soul. And then by vikshepatmaka, our attention is thrown out towards the pradhan, the ingredients. The Supreme Lord entered them and manifest all the objects of the world, but we're not seeing Supreme Lord, we're just seeing the objects, thinking that they're all separate individual material objects. We're in a state of distraction. So the second verse is an extending the explanation of the first verse. Krishna said, before the creation there was only me, after the creation there's only me, and in the middle there's only me. And if you're not seeing me, this is why. It is my maya. The jiva maya acts on you, and then you are seeing the world as something else. Vayam dvitya abhinivesha. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur also puts this verse in the second chapter. You are seeing as if there's something other than me. But as Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, Bahunam janmanamante gyanavam mam prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sa durlabha. After many births and deaths, when one is actually situated in knowledge, then what is that knowledge? Vasudeva sarvamiti. Krishna is everything. But such a great soul is very, very rare. So, here in the second chapter of Bhajan Rahasya, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is giving these verses explaining Jiva Tattva, the nature of the soul, Maya Tattva, the nature of illusion, Krishna Tattva, the nature of Krishna. Because in Sadhu Sangha we hear these and gradually our understanding of the nature of reality becomes clear. Now, in the second chapter, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur also gives the very famous verse, Nama Chintamani Krishnas Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Shuddha Puno Nityamukto Abhinatvam Nama Namino. The name of Krishna is like Chintamani. Chintamani is a jewel that fulfills all desires. Akama sarvakama vau mokshikama udharani. Whatever desire you have, material or spiritual, but especially spiritual, whatever desire you have, if you have a Chintamani, you hold it in your hand and you think of something, it becomes true. So the name of Krishna is like that. If you have your japamala in your hand and you chant, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Whatever is in your mind will become true, so be careful. Be careful what you have in your mind. Try to only pray for Sri Krishna's service. Nama Chintamani Krishna's Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. This name is Chaitanya, conscious. It is not a sound. It is fully conscious. Rasa Vigraha, the embodiment of all transcendental loving bellows. Purna Shuddho, it is Purna, complete. Here, the word complete in Sanskrit actually means the avyai, inexhaustible. In other words, from Krishna can manifest unlimited universes, unlimited. He's never depleted in any way. Whatever he, however his energy is manifest, he can manifest more and more and more. There's no end. So that is the meaning of complete. It's because in the material sense, something may be complete. And if you take one piece away, now it's incomplete. But this is complete. Something comes from it and it's still complete. Om Purnam Madaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasisyate. The Absolute Truth is complete and many complete units emanate from the complete, but it's not depleted. And they enter back into the complete and it remains complete. This, what this verse actually means is that Krishna is enjoying his pastimes in Goloka Vrindavan. But there are millions and millions of material universes, and in each universe there's one earth, and on each earth there's a Vrindavan. And that Leela from Goloka Vrindavan manifests on each of those Vrindavans. So from the complete Leela of Krishna manifests the complete Leela of Krishna in unlimited universes. And when the Leela is over, it becomes apricot again. Becomes unmanifest, enters back like this. So that is the secret meaning of this verse of the Ishupanishad. So Krishna's name is complete like that. All power is there. Purna Shuddho, it is pure. It is completely pure. It is not contaminated at all. Shuddho Nitya Mukto, it is eternal and always liberated beyond this plane. Why? Abhinatvam Namanamino. Because there is no difference at all between Krishna, Nanda Nanda, Shama Sundar, Gopinath, and this name, Krishna. Amazing. So, here, why is Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur presenting this verse? He's illustrating Shikshastakam, remember. So let's come to this. How Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is illustrating Shikshastakam. The second verse we're discussing. Nam Nam Akari Bahuda Nija Sarva Shakti. Oh my Lord, you have invested all your Shakti, all your potency in your holy name. So, the holy name is a prakrita vastu, supernatural substance. And the aprakrita vastu, supernatural substances, they have inconceivable potency. So here, nam namakari bahuda nija sarva shaktish means that, oh my Lord, you have unlimited names and you have put your powers in the names, but the powers which are in the names are related to those names. Understand? So God has primary and secondary names. The secondary names are related to the Srishti Leela, the pastimes of the creation. So if you say that Krishna is Paramatma, the Supreme Soul, who has manifested the universe, this is not a primary name. This is a secondary name because it relates to the creation. If you say Jagannath, then Lord of the universe, secondary name. If you say Brahman, then it is only his effulgence. Like this, so this is the secondary name. If you say Kirdakeshai Vishnu, like this, these are related to the world. Adikarta, the original doer. Jagadishwara, the controller of the universe, like all these are secondary, so they're called Gauna Nam, secondary names. Now the primary names, they are of two types, Aishwarya Nam and Madhurya Nam. The names which are primary, they refer to God in His own abode, but some are the names that refer to God in His opulent abodes of Vaikuntha, where he has a forearm form or whatever other not human-like form. Like the head of a lion, like Lord Nrisingadeva. Head of a horse, like Hayagriva. Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, the boar incarnation. So these are primary names because they're directly describing the forms of the Lord in His own abode. But there are Madhurya Nam. Those names refer to the Absolute Truth, Sri Krishna, in His Naravat Leela, human-like pastimes. So they will are very sweet, like Yashoda Nanda, the son of Madhyashoda. Subal Saka, the friend of Subal. Gopinath, the beloved of the gopis. Makanchur, the stealer of butter. Damodar, who, because he was naughty, his mother had to tie him up with a rope. Damodar. So, these are the primary names. So, Nam Namakari Bahudani Jasava Shaktish means that each name has a potency related to either the Gauna Leela, secondary, or the primary Leelas, or the name will have power of opulence or the name will be full of sweetness. So we want to take shelter of the names of Krishna that are full of sweetness. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is giving a very beautiful verse from Rupa Goswami's Namastaka. Aga damana yashoda nandano nandasuno kamala nayana gopi chandra brindavanendra pranata karun krishna vittaneka swarupe twayi mama rati uchcharvadatam namadeya. Can you see? No? Chapter 2. Look it up in the back. So, in the back there's an index of verses. The mool verses, the main verses, and then quoted verses. So it's in the mool, it's in the original verses, not among the quoted verses. So, Aga Damana Yashodananda Suno. Rupa Goswami is praying, oh Krishna, may my love for you in all these different forms, these different swaroops, increase moment by moment, at every moment. So, he's saying that from these, when a person utters these names, then they see the swarup of Krishna. But the swarup of Krishna is different depending on which name you quote. This is a principle in spiritual life. The inconceivable potency of the aprakritavastu, transcendental substances. You know, there's a verse that I think everyone knows. There's one verse everyone knows. And for many devotees, it's their favorite verse. Mahaprasadi Govinde Nama Brahmani Vaishnavi Swapapunyavatam Rajan Vishvaso Naiva Jayate. So, this verse is very, very deep. What is being expressed here? Mahaprasad. The prasad of Krishna is aprakritavastu, supernatural substance. It has tremendous power. It reveals the sweetness of Krishna and love for Him. Mahaprasade Govinde, the deity of Govindadev. Nama Brahmani here means Shabda Brahma, the name which is transcendental sound. Nama Brahmani, Shabda Brahma. Vaishnave and pure devotees. Sopapunna Patam Rajan. Those persons who have little piety, that means they have not served their guru. They have not engaged in bhakti under the guidance of pure devotees. So they have little piety. So those persons, Vishvaso Naiva Jayate, they don't have confidence. They cannot have trust. They don't believe in the power of Mahaprasada, in the power of the holy name, in the power of the deity, in the Mahaprasade Govinde Nama Brahmani Vaishnava, in the power of the Vaishnava association. But those who have served their spiritual master and engaged in bhakti under his guidance, they believe. Why? Because they have experience. All the transcendental things have a particular power. Rupa Goswami has described Lokottara Padathanam Prabhavaha Kopinagala Ratim Tadvishayam Chaso Vasate Turnam Ekada. The meaning is this. Lokottara Padathanam. Any Padartha, any substance which is Lokottara, beyond this world. So aprakrita, supernatural, transcendental. Any substance which is beyond this world. Lokottara Padathanam. Prabhav has an influence. And that influence, Prabhavaha Kopyanagala, it is Anarga. Anarga means like a bolt in a door. When the bolt is shut, then you cannot get out. you are limited to a particular area. But when it is anagala, the bolt is opened, then you are free and you can wander anywhere. So in the same way, ordinary substances, they have a limited power. If you eat ordinary food, then maybe you'll get some energy. You'll taste some sweetness for a second. There's limited power. But the transcendental things, Pabhava Kopinagala, they have been unbolted. They have unlimited power. One taste of prasadam, Mahaprabhu would go into ecstasy for days, tasting Jagannath Mahaprasadam. One name of Krishna, Sham, Sham, Sham. Radharani can't stop chanting the name of Krishna. The sweetness is unlimited. And what is the nature of that prabhav, the influence? Ratim tad vishayam chat so means rati, love. It causes the appearance of love, and tad vishay, the object of love. Basate means appearance. Vasamana prakashavat. The appearance in your consciousness. Turnam ekada. Turnam means immediately. And ekada means at one time. In other words, that when we touch the transcendental substance, the name of Krishna, Mahaprasadam, then when it touches that soft heart, immediately and at once, both Krishna and love for Krishna appear. This is the nature of the transcendental substances. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad gave an example. Once, in the village of Braja, one girl, she was from outside, but she was very lucky. Her parents arranged for her to marry a gop in Braja. So she came on a bullock cart to Braja, and she was staying in her mother-in-law's house. Her mother-in-law was very careful to protect her, that she should not go out of the inner garden of the house. Because in Braja there's one young boy, very notorious. So her mother-in-law was keeping her protected. But some of the sakis of Radharani met with her. And when they saw how beautiful and sweet, then they were thinking, oh, what a shame. Her life is wasted. Akshanvatam palamidam naparam vidhama sakya pasunna nuvibeshayato vayasa. Of all those living beings who have eyes, then the eyes are useless if they have never seen Krishna. So they were thinking, how can we extend some kindness to her? So then one of the sakis of Radhika, she came up with an idea. Let's give her some of Krishna's jute tambu. So they acquired some remnant of Krishna's tambu and they went to visit him. And they said, oh, we have something very tasty for you. Why don't you try this? So then she was very simple. And she tasted it. And as soon as she tasted it, she started to cry, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Why? Ratim tad vishayam chaso vasate turnam ekada. Because just by the touch of the aprakrita vastu, the supernatural substance, at once, at the same immediately and at the same time, Krishna, the spurti of Krishna came in our heart along with love for Krishna. So this is the meaning, nam namakari bahuda nicha sarvasha. That the names of Krishna have all potency. Prabhavako pinagala. The potency in these names, the bolt is off. Unlimited. Unstoppable. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur He is quoting this verse of Namastakam. Ah, Agadamana Yashoda Nandano Nandasuno Kamalanayana Gopichanda Brindavanendra Paratakarun Krishna Vitaneka Surupe Tvayi Mamarati Uchitarvada Tam Namadeya. May my love for you in these swarups, these different beautiful forms of Agadaman, Yashoda Nandan, and so on. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur even wrote a song which is expanding on this verse of Rupa Goswami. What song is that?
Hari Namatu.
Yes. Hari Namatu. Hare Goswarupa. Was touched by the tumble rampant of Krishna, she began to cry, Ha Krishna, Ha Krishna. And Krishna's Swarup manifested in her heart, and love for Krishna manifested in her heart. So in the same way, if we chant the holy name without offense, then because Nam is aprakritavastu, Nama Brahmani Vaishnava, it is among us. It is Krishna himself. Therefore, such sporty realization of Krishna's forms, pastimes and love for Krishna, they should manifest. And if it's not manifesting, then what? Duradaiva mitrishamiha jani nanuraga. How unlucky I am that I am not feeling that anxiety and weeping for Krishna. You see, this is the inner meaning of the second verse of Shikshastaka. So, agadamana yashoda nandano. Agadaman means one who defeats Agasura. So perhaps you know, one demon named Agasura came to Braja, assumed the form of a big python, and all the boys, the friends of Krishna, they said, Krishna, what's that over there? It looks like a huge python. His mouth is like a mountain cave. His top lip is touching the sky. His long tongue is like a freeway. And his teeth are sticking up like jagged rocks, like mountain tops. And that fishy smell in the air is his undigested lunch. Some boy said, let's go inside and play. Another boy said, well, I don't think that's probably not a good idea. It could be dangerous. Another boy said, don't worry, Krishna's here. Because Gargacharya said, Anina Sarva Durgane Yuyam Anjastari Tarisyata. That anyone who loves Krishna, then whatever problems come in their life, they cross over it. Very easy, all obstacles will be overcome. So don't worry. And all the boys said, yes, let's go. And they were running down the hill, climbing over his teeth, onto his tongue, running along his tongue. And they all went into the mouth of Agasura. Krishna was trying to stop them. No, don't go, don't go. But they went this way, this way, this way. He failed. He could not stop them. And as he saw them going into the mouth of Agasura, tears came in his eyes. What will happen to my friends? This is called Karun Rasa. The rasa of compassion. What will happen to my friends? And then Jogamaya came and revealed to Krishna. Then Krishna, he was only 5 years old. First he was crying, what will happen to my friends? And then Jogamaya revealed his knowledge. It's okay, I'm Balavan. I'll save them. So in Vrindavan, Krishna never knows that he's God. But Yogamaya, his Leela Shakti allows him to know sometimes when he needs to save his friends or help the bridge buses in danger. So then Krishna, he ran after his friends and went inside the mouth of Agasura. When they went inside, they all died from the poisonous fumes of the snake's poison. So Krishna went inside and went into the throat of Agasura. And then he looked around. He saw that all the boys were unconscious. Now usually we've been hearing this song, Putana Gatana Trinavartana Shakata Banja. When Krishna killed Putana, he didn't manifest any superhuman form. Of course he had power, but when he killed Putana, he didn't use a chakra or anything. He just sucked her breast like a baby, but he took her prana. When Krishna killed Trinavarta, he didn't use any opulent method. He didn't come riding on Garuda. But rather, he just held on to Trinavarta like a baby holds onto your neck, and he crashed down from the sky. When Krishna killed Shakatasura, the cart demon, he was just lying on his back and kicking his toes. So he did everything like a human child. That is Madhurya Leela. Why? Because his mother and others were watching. So he will not manifest any opulence in front of them. But now he was inside the mouth of Agasura. His mother was not there. All the boys were unconscious. So then he said, okay, no problem. And he began to expand his body. He became bigger and bigger until he choked the throat of Agasura. And Agasura's Atma, soul, exploded from the top of his head. And then Krishna, by his glance, he brought the boys back to life again. And they all came out to play. So, Agadaman, if you chant the name, oh, Agadaman, then you can see this Leela. You can see the pastime. But also, Aga Aga means sins. And what is the result of sin? Suffering. So from the point, the sambandha, the relationship of the gopis of Vrindavan, in a sweet way, Aga means we are suffering so much in separation from Krishna. During the daytime when he goes to take the cows to the forest, we are trapped in our homes. But at night, he plays his flute at Bangsibat and we sneak out and go through the forest and meet with him. So then when we meet with him, then he is Agadama. He kills all suffering of separation by his beautiful glance, by his beautiful smile. Stira chara brjinatna susmita sri mukhina brjapura panitanam vadi and kama deva. So his name is Agadama. Agadamana Yashodanandano. He is Yashodananda. Madhi Yashoda loves Krishna so much. Even when Krishna has grown and become Kishore, she still thinks he's like my child. In the morning time, everyone wakes up except for Krishna still. Because he's so tired from dancing the whole night on the bank of the Jamuna, he cannot wake up. So Madhi Yashoda and Purnamasi Devi come into his room. And Madhi Yashoda lifts up sleepy Krishna, wipes his face with a wet cloth to refresh him and give him some sweets. And she sees that Krishna is not wearing a pitambar. He's wearing blue cloth of Radharani. Because when Radharani realized it was getting late and had to go home, they just grabbed cloth and ran. So Radhika grabbed Krishna's cloth and Krishna grabbed Radhika's cloth and they just ran. And now he's lying in it. And Madhya Shoda sees and thinks, oh, how sweet. Krishna's wearing Balram's cloth. Because she has parental mood, she doesn't think of any madurasa. Oh, Krishna and Balram have swapped their clothing. And she picks Krishna up. She sees some scratches on his chest. Those boys, they play so rough. Why do they wrestle with him so roughly? She sees here and there, there's some red kumkum from Braja Gopis, and she thinks because the cowboys, they get Gaidic tattoo, red minerals from the stones in the forest, and they paint Krishna. I think, oh, the boys, they put so much Gaidic tattoo on my son. And very happily, she's waking him up in the morning and thinking all very sweet parental thoughts about him, having no idea what her son is up to. Agadamana Yashodanandano. How much nectar is in any name of Krishna? It is unlimited. Agadamana Yashodanandano Nandasuno. Krishna is Nandasuno, the son of Nanda Maharaj. When Krishna was born, Nanda Maharaj was so proud. He was old, like late middle aged, and he never had a child, but now he had a son, he became so proud. So when a father has a son, then he has to go to the river and take a ceremonial bath. So Nanda Baba, he's like has a bit of a belly, but he puts on a cloth around here. Pulls it up. And he has a moustache and beard. His beard is like a mixture of sesame seed and mustard seeds. Black and white mixed together. And he set off to the Jamuna for his ceremonial bath. He was so happy. And you know they have these steps going down and then there are these like jetties that come out. Little piers with the pagodas, pavilions on the top, you see in Vrindavan. So he came to Jamuna, he didn't go down the steps to bath, he was so happy, he came to the top and dive into one from very high. All the bridge buses, he, so where did he go? Where did he go? They didn't see him for a few minutes. What happened? And then Nanda Baba jumped up from the water and was swimming around. He's a very good swimmer. He was swimming around. He was so happy. I've got a son. I've got a son. Bridge Basu said, come on, come on, come home. You have to get dressed and get ready for the ceremonies. So Nanda Baba came home. He loves Krishna so much. Sometimes he takes Krishna and Balaram to the Jamuna and he swims with them also. And then after bathing in the Jamuna, then he puts Krishna on one shoulder and Balaram on the other and carries them. His two boys. So, Nanda Baba has such deep love for Krishna, and Krishna has deep love for Nanda Baba also. From the point of view of Braja Gopis, he is the son of Nanda Maharaj. Jayo Jayo Ballabha Raj Kumar. The same thing. Ballabha Raj. He is the son of the king of Braja. When Gopis say this, it means the prince, the son of the king, is very powerful. How powerful is he? Oh, not in the presence of my Saki. We'll see. Radha Vakshasi Harimani Har. He is just like a necklace of the emeralds on the chest of our Saki Radhika. So, Nandasuno means in Madhuras, Krishna is the prince, he is the son of the king, he is very powerful. Yes, we know how powerful he is. Radha Vakshasi Harimani Har. Harimani means emerald. What color is an emerald?
Green.
Green. But I thought Krishna was Shyamsundar. When Krishna is, oh, feels his whole life is a success, being in the embrace of Radhika, then mera baba padharo radha nagar soy jatan ki jai pare shyam harit dyuti hoy. When the bluish Krishna is bathed in the golden complexion of Radhika, he becomes green. Shyam harita dyuti hoy. When the, because blue and yellow makes green, so Krishna is bluish, and the aura of Radhika, due to her love, her aura is spreading out and covers Krishna, and so he takes on a hue like emerald. So Radha Vakshasi Harimaniha. The necklace is a decoration. The person is the main thing and the decoration is extra. So Radhika is the main thing and Krishna is the decoration. Agadamana Yashoda Nandano Nandasuno Kamalanayana. Krishna is Kamalanayana. Means his eyes are like lotuses. A lotus is full of nectar. So his glance is full of nectar. And the lotus is reddish. His eyes are reddish because, you know, if someone has been drinking so much, then the eyes become red. So from Madhupan Leela, drinking honey wine with Radhika, his eyes have become red. But it was not the honey wine that intoxicated him. It was Adharamrita, the nectar of Radhika, that caused him to be intoxicated. And also, if you are awake for the whole night, then eyes become red. So he is Kamalanayan. Agadamana Yashoda Nandano Nandasuno Kamalanayana Gopi Chandra. Gopi Chandra. He's like the moon of the Braj Gopis. You know that the gopis, they're like chakora birds. A chakora bird cannot live without tasting the moonbeams. So in the same way, Braj Gopis, they cannot live without drinking the sweet rays of effulgence from the face of Krishna. And the moon is also called Rasamrita Murti. The flavor of food comes from the flavor of plants, the power of herbs and vegetables comes from the rays of the moon. So the moon gives rasa to everything. So ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavitabis. All the Brajagopis become infused with rasa from Gopichandra Krishna. Agadamani Yashoda Nanda No Nanda Suno Kamala Nayana Gopichandra Brindavanendra. Brindavanendra. He is the Nath, the Lord of the forest of Brindavan. Just like Indra enjoys his Nandakanana, the gardens of heaven with his associates. But see, Krishna is like the Indra of the forest of Vrindavan, Vrindavan Indra. Pranata Karun means he gives Karun mercy to those who bow down to him. Krishna Vityaneka Surupayo Krishna. You have many different names, and each name has a swarup, a form. May my rati, my attachment for all of your names, grow day by day by day. May it always increase. Because namna makari bahuda nija sarvashantish. The aprakita vastu, the supernatural substance, has an unlimited potency to manifest the form of Krishna and love for Krishna at the same time. Radhika herself experienced this when she was young, before she had the chance to meet with Krishna directly. One day, Vishakha Sakhi made a painting. Sucharu Vaktra Mandala Sukarna Ratna Kundala Sucharche Tanga Chandana Namami Nandana Namami Nandana Namami Nandana Namami Nandana Namami Nandana. She painted Sucharu Vaktra Mandala, a beautiful face. Sukarna Ratna Kundala, she painted earrings. Sucharchitanga Chandanam, she began to paint the body and put real sandalwood paste on it. She was using sandalwood paste, jewels, everything, making a beautiful picture of Krishna. Sudirga Netra Pankajam, she painted his beautiful eyes. And when Radhika looked at the eyes in the painting, then the eyebrows moved. She was looking and the painting was looking back at her. Moving eyebrows. And Radhika began to cry. Ekasya srutameva lumpati matim krishneti namaksharam sandra ananda sandrunmada paramparam upanayo anyasya bangsi kala esha snigda ganajuti manasime lagna pate vikshanat kastam dit purushatraye ratirabun manye miti seyasi. Radhwani said, oh, it would be better for me to die. Why? Because ekasasutameva lumpatimatim, I heard one syllable of a name. What was that? Ekasya srutameva lumpatimatim krishneti namakshara. Only one akshara. One syllable. Krish. And immediately when I heard Krish, then my mati, that means my intelligence, was completely destroyed. Demolished. Nothing left. It was a shock. The sound came. Krish. All intelligence was completely gone. Only one syllable.
Solo una sílaba.
Long petit matin. Long petit. Here is in the present tense. Why? It's as if it happened just now. It was in the past. But when that happened, the syllable caused a very beautiful person to appear in my heart with very particular characteristics and qualities, very, very attractive. Sandra Mara Paramparam Upano Anyasubangsi Kala. And then, in the distance, I heard that far away, someone was playing a flute. And when the sound of that flute entered my ear, then, you see, previously my intelligence was destroyed, and now what was left of my mind, that became completely mad. Sandron Mara Paramparam. So intelligence was smashed, and the rest of my mind became insane. Sandron Mara Paramparam Upanayata Upanayati. In the present tense. Why? Because it's as if it's happening right now, though it was in the past. And as it's happening, at once, I'm seeing another person with a very beautiful form and very particular qualities, different from the qualities of that person. See? Harinam to Aneka Sarup. Different names reveal Krishna's qualities. But because of the intensity of Radhika's love, her anurag is tasting this particular quality in this form and another particular quality in another form. Then she said, Aisha snigdha ganajuti masrimei lagna pate vikshna. And now Vishakha, you have shown me the very dark but shining, sham sundar complexion of this person in the picture. Now my heart has become attached to him. Because another spurti, she see. Now, three persons are standing in her heart. Each one of them, beautiful and unique in his own way. And quite different. So then she said, kastam purushatai ratirabun mandye mriti sreyasi. For a chaste young woman from a good family, from a dynasty with a great historical reputation, to become attached to a man other than her husband is terrible infamy. But what happened to me? I've fallen in love with three other men. So why should I stay alive? Oh, it would be better for me to die at once. Alas, alas. And Radhika began to cry. So this is the Prabhava Anagala, the unlimited power of the name of Krishna, the qualities of Krishna, the forms of Krishna. Nam nam akari bahuda nija savashati. All the power is there in Krishna Nam. So, we are very fortunate to be the followers of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He has expanded on this verse in the song Hari Namatua Anek Surupa. Also every morning we're singing Vibhavari Shesha Aloka Pravesha Nidha Jari Udhoti Sudara Sagayo Krishna Yasha Rakova Chanamanamur. Oh, my dear mind, remember all of these names, they are full of rasa. So we are very fortunate to come into the line of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Try to sing these names every day and remember Krishna in all of these forms. Actually, this song, there is no Aishwarya in this song whatsoever. This is only all Madhurya Rasa following the moods of Braja Gopis. If you sing them every day, then the... Then, Vatim Tanvishayam Chaso. Krishna and love for Krishna will come into the heart at the same time immediately. So these songs are full of rasa, very sweet. Rama Krishna Hayagriva. Hayagriva? Who is Hayagriva? Hayagriva is the avatar of the Supreme Lord, who is considered to be the embodiment of all Vedic knowledge and all wisdom, material and spiritual. Yes. At the beginning of the creation, when Lord Brahma wanted to create, then he manifested the Vedas and two demons came, Madhu and Kaitava. And they came and they stole the Vedas from Brahma. But then the Supreme Lord, Hayagriva, appeared and killed Madhu and Kaitava and re-established the Vedic knowledge. Madhu and Kaitava means the incarnations of tamas and rajas. Where tamas and rajas is there, there can be no knowledge. And so Hayagriva came and established the Vedas. So Gargacharya says that Tasman Nandatmajo Yamte Narayana Samogunai, O Nanda Maharaj, your son will have qualities or just like Narayan. Having qualities like Narayan, that means in Tattva, Krishna and Narayan are one. From the point of view of Tattva, philosophy, metaphysics, ontology, Krishna and Narayan, they are one. Advaita, Machuta, Manari, Mananta, Rupa. Siddhanta Tosta Bede Be Sri Sa Krishna Sarupaya Rasana Krishna Krishna Rupa Mesha Risastiti. There is no difference between Lord Narayan and Krishna according to Siddhanta, but there's a difference according to rasa. So he has qualities like Narayan, means that according to Siddhanta, he is the same. But according to rasa, Krishna has more qualities. Lord Narayan has only 64, my friend. He has 64 qualities. He was thinking, oh, I love dancing in kirtan, I wish I had 1,000 legs. So the meaning is Lord Narayan has 60 qualities and Krishna has those 60 qualities also, but to a greater degree. But Krishna also has the four Madhuris, Leela Madhuri, Venu Madhuri, Rupa Madhuri and Prema Madhuri, more than Lord Narayan. But gopis heard Krishna has qualities like Narayan. So the qualities of all the various avatars, they must be present in Krishna. So Hayagriva is a speaker of the Vedic knowledge. Just like in Rasalila, when Krishna played his flute and Braj Gopis abandoned everything, they came running to meet with him. And then Krishna said, welcome to the forest. Why did you come here? Is there a problem in your house? You can tell me. Anyway, I think you should return now. Pratiyata vrajam nehasteyam srivi sumadhyama. Pratiyata means return. Pratiyata vrajam, to braj. Neham, pratiyata vrajam neha, not here. Steyam, stay. Return to braj, not here, stay. But his real meaning was return to Braj, not stay here. He is very tricky. But gopis are heartbroken. What do we do? So then Sri Krishna said, Aswagamayasyam cha Falagu Krishnam Bayavayam Jugupsitam Chasavatra Hyopapatyam Kulastriya. You are Kulastri, you are from a very respectable family. So, all the scriptures explain, and it's understood everywhere, that to have upapati, a paramour, is aswargyam, it will not leave to heaven. So aswargyam, it will not go to take you to heaven. Gopis were thinking, we don't want to go to heaven. So then Krishna thought, aswargyam ayashashvam, it will not lead to good reputation and fame. Gopi said, we don't care for fame, we throw it away. Oh, meeting with the paramour will be vulgu. That means it gives a happiness, very meager, insignificant happiness. Gopis thought, no, it's not an insignificant happiness. Once we touched your lotus feet, and only touching your lotus feet, we felt such happiness that even Lakshmi Devi, the goddess of fortune, would consider this a great festival. But she has no chance. So then Krishna said, Kritscham! Oh, it is full of suffering, full of difficulty. Gopis were thinking, in the Rasa Shastra, it is said that if there's a difficulty in meeting one's beloved, then this increases the rasa. Krishna said, Bayavayam, and it is a cause of fear, because all society are against it. Gopis remembered also that Bharat Muni has said that if there is a lover and beloved, they should not meet, because all society says, forbids it. Then when the heroine goes and meets secretly and against all dharma with her beloved, she feels more joy. So then Krishna said, Jugupsitam, it is condemned everywhere. So in this way, Krishna is like Hayagriva, giving all the teachings of the Vedas. But the gopis never accept his words. Yat patya patya suridama nubritiranga strinam swadama iti davat vidatva yuktam asto itam eva mupadesh padetva ishe prastova bangstanubitam kila bandhu atma. O Krishna, you have given us instructions according to the rules of dharma. So you are our guru. And everyone knows pratamantu gurum pujam tatastaiva mamachanam. You have to serve guru first, before anyone else, even before the Supreme Lord. Also, Gargacharya has said that you have all the qualities like the Supreme Lord. So when a wife is serving her husband, she's not serving the body. The idea of dharma is that she's serving the Paramatma in the heart. Because if the husband dies, then Ram Nam Satyahe, you have to carry him to the ghat and set fire to his body. So the service is actually to the Paramatma in the heart. So we heard that Gargacharya said, you have all the qualities like Paramatma. So the actual true husband of the soul is you. So we'll stay here and serve you. In this way, gopis cut Krishna's words with tears in their eyes. Afterwards, Krishna was laughing and he accepted them. They said, why did you tell us this? Oh, we should not serve you because it will not go to heaven if we have an association with the upapati. Krishna said, I never said that. I never said that. I said upapati. The word pati, husband, comes from apatta, what you attain through dharma. And upa can mean the opposite of that. So upapati means beloved who you attain not through dharmic channel. Upapati. But upa can also mean not just opposite, but upa can mean samipe, close. So I said upapati, by being close to your husband, you will not go to heaven. Very clearly I said it. But you said, that if we meet with you, then this will be Falgu, very small happiness, but Christian, great difficulty. No, I never said that. I said Falgu, Christian. It'll only be a small difficulty. What is that small difficulty? Aslishava padartam pinashtumam. Krishna is very strong, and sometimes when he embraces so tightly that there's little pain. So that is a Falgu, Christian. So in this way, Braj Krishna is giving Vedic instructions to the gopis. And gopis cut all of his ideas. Afterwards, Krishna denies, I never said any of those things. So he's like Hayagriva. Rama Krishna Hayagriva Nishingaba. He's like Vamandev. Vamandev is such a cheat, you know? Vamandev is the first incarnation to introduce cheating to the Leela. He came like a dwarf. Bali Maharaj said, I want to give you something in charity. Ask for me whatever you want. He said, I only want 3 steps of land. And he promised to give, but then he became huge and took everything. So Krishna is like this. Oh, just come, just for a minute into this kunch. By trick, always by tricks, but he takes everything. So he's like Vaman. Ravanantakara Makara. Ravanantakara. Lord Ram. He came across the ocean to save Sita Devi. Sita Devi was so sad sitting in Ashok Vatika, crying. She'd been kidnapped and held hostage by Ravan in the Ashok Vatika. Oh, when will my beloved come and save me? She was so sad. So in the same way, Braj Gopis are trapped in their homes by their demonic husbands. And they think, when will Krishna's qualities like Ram, when will he come and save me? So in this way, Putana Gatana, just by the touch of Krishna's lips, Putana's life was gone. So here, it is not in relation to the childhood pastimes, only it is in relation to the goon, the quality. That means that Krishna's lips, the touch of Krishna's lips is very, very powerful. So in this way, all these names are full of madhurasa. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is quoting this as Agadamana Yashoda Nandano Nandasuno to illustrate the second verse of Shikshastakam, Nam Nam Akari Bahudani Jasavasaktis. Tibhuvramakari Sri Hari Nam Prabhu Ki Jai.